Hello everyone. This morning I'm meeting Professor Nishit Narang.
Hello everyone.
Well, he's a group leader and associate professor in Computer Science and Information Systems Department at BITS Pilani Work Integrated Learning Programs Division. He's an expert in computers and communication networks and cybersecurity. Well, Professor Nishit has extensive experience working on various IT projects in areas such as terrestrial, satellite and mobile communications, smart city solutions and consumer wearables. Thank you so much for sparing your time out and interacting with me today.
It's my pleasure to be here.
So Professor Nishit, I'm a self-confessed cloud computing enthusiast. And it is no surprise that in the future, because of cloud computing, we might not just need hard drives at all. So I was also reading on the BITS Pilani Work Integrated Learning Programs website that cloud computing is going to lead India's digital transformation story and the growth story in the near future. So I would love to hear your views on this, sir.
Well, cloud computing happens to be one of the fastest growing domains today. And there are various reasons to that. We have a growing digital population. If you look at enterprises, they are heavily focused towards digital transformation. All of this is giving acceleration to the domain of cloud computing. If you look at one of the reports that came out of NASSCOM, they're projecting about $380 billion being added to the GDP of India, almost 14 million jobs getting added, and all this by the year 2026. This spells a big potential, a large opportunity for cloud professionals. Engineers can really benefit by building cloud computing skills and look at targeting this market.
So, sir, as you're mentioning, there are 14 million job opportunities. So I would like to ask you, as a working professional, how do I prepare myself to grab one of those job opportunities?
I would suggest you start by building knowledge in the area. Develop skills in the domain of cloud computing. We at BITS Work Integrated Learning Program have designed the M.Tech Cloud Computing Program keeping this in mind. When you do this program, you will encounter courses like Big Data Systems, Network Fundamentals for Cloud, Security Fundamentals for the Cloud, Building Cloud Native Applications, even a course on Cloud Economics. In essence, the program is aimed at making a cloud expert out of the working professionals and thereby help fulfill the gap that exists in the industry.
So, sir, you just mentioned about BITS Pilani WILP offering an M.Tech in cloud computing. So I, being an IT professional, am keenly looking forward to building a career in cloud computing. So in your honest opinion, do you think this would be the right program for me?
It absolutely is. As an IT professional, I'm assuming you already have basic programming experience. Along with exposure to the IT domain via either your academic or industry association. So that's the prerequisite for this program. The program is suitable for aspiring cloud administrators, solution architects, DevOps engineers, application developers working on cloud-native solutions, or even migrating existing solutions to the cloud. Some of the working professionals may have already taken a foundational, associate, or professional level cloud certification course, maybe from AWS or from Azure. They may still want to enhance their conceptual understanding provided by an academic program and link it with practice. And this will help them further their career progress. The program is suited for all such working professionals.
So, sir, there are many programs being offered in the market. And as a working professional, this really confuses me often. So I wanted to know, how can I be 100% sure that this program is for me?
Well, that's a valid concern. Let me answer that by saying that BITS Pilani is an institute of eminence. And you will get to attend lectures by BITS Pilani faculty, as well as attend special talks delivered by industry experts. The program has an adequate mix of theory and practice, with experiential learning components that ensure holistic learning. So essentially,
this program has all the ingredients that can take a working professional like you to further career progress in the cloud computing domain.
So, sir, I downloaded the brochure for the program from the WILP website. And I happen to see there are many courses such as big data systems, cloud computing and many others. So could you just elaborate on the various courses being offered in this program?
Well, that's a good question. You would actually need to take 12 courses spread across 3 semesters. The compulsory courses include Introduction to Parallel and Distributed Programming, Network Fundamentals for the Cloud, Big Data Systems, Cloud Computing, Cloud Infrastructure and Systems Software, and Distributed Computing. And then you will also need to complete a project in the final semester.
And also, sir, the program offers a lot of electives as well, so we get an opportunity to choose from them. So can you just elaborate on that aspect as well?
You will have electives such as edge computing, cloud economics, infrastructure management, DevOps for cloud, and many more.
So sir, would we also have a lot of practical exposure along with the theory courses in the program so that we are job ready once the program is done?
Absolutely. The M.Tech cloud computing program provides a healthy mix of class lectures and experiential learning components. The demos, the hands-on labs and assignments are all enabled on public cloud-based lab infrastructures. These services range from using virtual machines, container clusters, object storage, databases, and machine learning APIs so that you can build and manage an end-to-end application. You can use open source code bases and tools to build a cloud platform and test it on a virtual machine. You get to play with Kubernetes clusters, API gateways, serverless options, and databases to practically experiment with various building blocks of a public cloud platform. There are project-oriented courses where you can take a real business problem and build an end-to-end cloud-native solution throughout a semester using various cloud services. Overall, the M.Tech Cloud Computing Program provides you with a great opportunity to complement the fundamental academic concepts you learn in class lectures with implementation experiments using specific cloud vendor services.
So that's indeed a lot of learning, sir. I actually can't wait to enroll in the program and do the learning and apply all that knowledge at my workplace.
Yes, so this is a work integrated learning program where you will actually be encouraged to apply the concepts that you learn at your workplace. Through this program, you will gain expertise in understanding the design and development of cloud native applications using the existing services and APIs, as well as the design and architectural choices which are involved in building a cloud platform more from a provider perspective. You will better interpret pricing and billing strategies for a cloud platform and identify the cost optimization opportunities which create a technical solution architecture better from a cost perspective. You will get the opportunity to enhance your learning through case studies, through simulations, and using a cross-vendor public cloud-based lab infrastructure. Plus, you will be able to apply the knowledge gained to real-world business problems during the final semester when you do the dissertation project. In the final semester, you actually work on a real-world complex project drawn from your organization. You will apply the concepts learned in the first 3 semesters of this program towards the dissertation project that you will eventually do. In summary, you will be able to design a cost-optimized solution for a given use case or application by considering fitment of various cloud services, considering non-functional attributes of the solution, as well as billing plans for various available services.
So, sir, after all these talks, there is something that is bothering me. So, I am a working professional, and do you think I would be able to manage this program without a career break? And further, how will I manage academics and work together?
That's a concern a lot of working professionals have. But working professionals like yourself can pursue WILP programs without taking any career breaks, as classes are conducted online, typically happening over weekends. Lectures are also recorded. So even if you miss out on a lecture, you can catch up by going through the recorded content. Further, our state-of-the-art virtual labs are all remote labs, and they are available 24/7 by 365 days a year. And that allows you to perform all your experiments remotely from wherever you are and at whatever time that you can take out. So you will indeed be able to manage your academics and work together, given that our programs have a very, very flexible design.
And sir, do we have to take some examinations as well?
You absolutely have to. While the program is designed in a way that your existing work-life balance is not impacted, the academic rigor of this program is just like any other on-campus program. Consequently, the degree that you receive upon successful completion of the program, it's equivalent to an on-campus degree. Semester 1, 2, and 3 have mid-semester examinations and comprehensive examinations for each of the courses. These examinations are mostly scheduled over weekends. There'll also be quizzes, assignments conducted online. In semester 4, when you're doing the final dissertation project, you're doing project work as per the institute's guidelines. For each course in each semester, you will typically have 3 evaluation components spread over the semester. The weightage for each of the components varies from course to course. Assignment, quizzes, which happen online, typically are 15 to 30% weightage. Mid-semester exams have typical 30 to 40% weightage, whereas the comprehensive exams are typically 35 to 50% weightage.
While I was browsing through the WILP website, it was mentioned that on successful completion of the program, I would become a part of the elite and global community of the BITS Pilani alumni. So, sir, how would becoming a part of this community benefit me?
That's a very good question. BITS Pilani is an institute of eminence and has wide and diverse alumni base spread across the globe, working in various sectors. This network can be invaluable for professional growth, mentorships, and opportunities. Alumni can utilize the state-of-the-art facilities, libraries, and labs available at BITS campuses. In essence, being a BITS Pilani alumnus is not just about holding a degree from a prestigious institution, it is about being a part of a dynamic and supportive community that fosters personal and professional growth throughout one's life. So I hope I've answered all your questions.
Absolutely, sir. I can't wait to be a part of this program, actually. And thank you so much, sir.
My pleasure. I hope to see you in classroom.